two uninhabited Pacific islands. More than 5,000 miles from the UK.
One will be inhabited by 14 British men, while a separate island will be home to 14 British women. For 6 weeks, they'll be utterly alone. Hey! With only the clothes they stand up in and a handful of basic tools. Filming everything themselves.
When pushed to the limits of human endurance,
will it be brute power?
Big chin, big fella! Ooh, snap it!
Or mental strength that wins the day?
They're too cute. I can't.
Who will
have what it takes to stay alive?
Tonight we follow the men's island.
It's a scorpion, guys.
It'll be harder than ever.
They'll have to endure the height of the harsh tropical storm season.
A bit like being in a disaster film.
They'll have to find their own water.
Yeah!
And hunt for their own food.
Watch him, watch him. Go now, go now.
That is amazing.
Have these modern-day men got what it takes to survive?
We're all sweating our bollocks off up there, fella, and it looks like...
Yeah, fair enough.
Looks like you're doing call when it comes to wood.
Weeks ago, 14 British men were cast away on this remote Pacific island.
Woo! That was the damnedest thing I ever did.
But now, three of the men have quit.
Now the dead weight's f***ed off, let's get on with it.
And the island has taken its toll on the 11 that remain.
I've never been so terrified in my life.
You finally see why.
Having barely found anything substantial to eat, they're now on the brink of starvation.
We ain't conquered jack shit. Nothing.
It's a bit like being in a disaster film, or, you know, or... when you hear on the news that people have had a typhoon come through or a flood. There's no water, there's no electricity, there's no food supply. Sometimes out here can feel like you've been hit by a major disaster.
Oh, look, another day in paradise.
It's been 15 days since the men arrived on the island. And so far, they have survived on a meagre diet of a few hundred calories a day.
So thin now, like ribs, all sorts of like bones appearing that I haven't seen since I was a bloody teenager.
Oh, hang on. Oh, hang on.
Lie down, mate, if you...
Ooh. It's the nearest I've got to fainting, or what I assume is fainting, having never fainted before, but my vision just went, like, pulsated, in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. And then before I knew it, I was on my ass. Sort of semi-collapsed.
We're surviving off limpets and, like, the odd one fish. It's not going to sustain us for the next couple of weeks. And I think another week of this, we'll be struggling massively just to even get up in the morning. We need to find a solid source of food or, you know, we could be facing meltdown.
We're out of food. The bottom line is we don't have any food other than limpets. We're getting weaker and weaker. I certainly feel like I'm getting weaker and weaker. So my priority is how I feel about it personally is food. I think the majority of our resources should be to getting us a good fish today.
Let's go. We are going to find lunch.
Come on, fishy, fishy, fishy.
In a survival situation, you always face one huge dilemma, and that is if you want to eat, you got to hunt.
Hunting burns for energy, and there's no guarantee you're actually going to catch anything at the end of it.
Any glimmers yet, Vic?
Oh, I can see fish.
Can you?
Bastard, you.
Every time you go looking for food, you're gambling. You're gambling with your energy reserves.
No, Piers, you seem a bit lacking in enthusiasm.
Oh, so... I was dead on my feet. Absolutely dead on my feet. I feel just completely gone.
You just keep nibbling it straight off end. The luck of the gods is not with us today.
Everyone's getting tired. Everyone's hungry. Everyone's sick of bacon bit limpets. We need some decent food. We need it quick. If we don't get it soon, it's going to start cracking like fires.
Despite the group's desperation, one man refuses to be beaten.
Let's all push it to the edge. I feel fine. Another day at the office. I feel really good, yeah.
Vic wants to change tactics and take the hunt to an unexplored part of the island. 1 kilometre from camp is a vast freshwater lagoon where he believes a much bigger prize could be lurking. One that could provide the group with the calories they so desperately need.
We are going hunting for Mr. Cayman. Let's go lay some traps, fellas. Let's go hunt some beast.
As well as the search for food, the men's survival depends on them having a constant supply of drinking water. They need at least 30 litres a day, which they must collect on a back-breaking 2 kilometre round trip.
Sam, when you go past Carl, can you ask him to come and help do the water run, please?
He's not shirking, is he?
Hey, I'm just saying the water run he's doing, and he's chewing his gums. You do the maths. Right, let's go grab Carl. Kyle, are those crocs going to be okay for going across to get some water?
Is anyone else knocking about to do water? I've done a lot of mileage the last few days. I think I'd rather do something a bit more camp-based today.
I've done water 2 days in a row, mate, so yeah. This is my third day, so...
Yeah, you know. Appreciate it. Well, we've got 11 people here.
But they're not here now, mate. Yeah.
Kyle, why don't they just sit here and tidy the camp, then? I'll do it.
That's no problem, mate. Cheers.
Cheers, thanks, Pierce. Right, off we go.
Just sat in the office in front of the screens. I know there's more to life than that, so I just got to a stage where I wanted to break away from it, step away from the screens and just do something different. I like to think I can step up to most challenges. I like to see myself as someone who will see things through to the end, so... If I was the person who was struggling in the group and was a useless one, that would be a big knock to my confidence. Big knock.
I was a little disappointed in Kyle. It would have been nice if he just stepped up to the plate and said, you know what, I'll step in, but he wasn't in the mood to do that today.
It's not so much that I'm hungry. The worst thing is just the energy. I never for a second thought my energy would be as low as it has been. Fuck. I can't even lift up my legs.
Now keep an eye out for Mr. Fucking Gert. If you see Cayman, I'll scream.
Yes. How big did they say they get? Fuck's not gonna eat me.
6 foot the Cayman and 6 meters the alligator.
Oh, these are alligators.
Yeah.
Fuck it.
I don't know where Vic gets his energy, but I need half of that energy. Because Vic has got energy all the way through the day. If I could take anything away from this island, I would like to be a little bit more like Vic Fellows.
See, like that. That is actual shit. What the fuck is this, Jurassic Park? That's not shit.
That's shit.
That's not shit, fellas.
What is it?
That's mud out of there.
Do you know what it is? I'm sure there's a T-Rex here.
Oh, fuck, that's great.
What do you do? if you see something snapping at your feet, what are you going to do? You're going to just machete it?
Worst case scenario, if I can't, we can't pin him, what have you. I'm fighting for my life, it's having it, isn't it?
Yeah.
As best as a facilities manager can do. I'm 47, this could be my last crazy hurrah. And what better way to doing it than the ultimate challenge of surviving? I mean, it is the ultimate challenge. Can I provide for me?
Hey, Andy.
Beautiful, Victor. Yes, I am very excited. It's Boy Scout shit, isn't it? We're all over it. We get knives and spears and stuff, maybe even a bow and arrow to make. I mean, how good does it get? Excited is an understatement. Yes, sometimes I have to keep... put a lid on it to not let it get like, boom, shit! That kind of excitement, yeah.
So just keep quiet, keep quiet, guy, because if there is a croc, we'll see it.
Where do caimans live?
I don't know. I presume they lived in the water.
I thought they lived up trees. Do caimans live in holes?
I reckon caimans live in holes.
Dear.
Well, I'm making that up, but...
It sounds good, though. Get something bollocks, I'm coming out.
Crocodiles are ambush predators. They hunt their prey in shallow waters and are masters of the stealth attack.
The razor-sharp teeth and a bite is three times more powerful than a lion.
Sam.
Shh. That is a caiman.
Look, he's up. Fuck, he's a biggie.
That there is our baby. That is dinner, yeah. That is our dinner.
Would it be worth swimming in?
Not for me. I'm not swimming in that. Not a chance. That is insanity, yeah.
Fucking bastard, him. Look, look, he's moving. He's got a bit of a ripple behind him. Look at that size of that fucking head. He's getting inquisitive, he's that little boy, isn't he? Come to daddy. We now need to find where he comes in and goes out.
Okay. Wherever we are now,
yeah,
is where they come out.
Yeah, dead right.
That is where crocs come out of the water.
Yeah, that is perfect, isn't it?
I'm gonna make a snare there, right towards the water.
You ever caught anything in a snare before?
Have I ever made a snare before? No.
Oh, he's there, he's back.
Where?
Straight away, see him? He fucker's got closer as well, hasn't he? That shifty little bastard's got closer, hasn't he? He's not scared of us.
You'd have to keep an eye on him while I'm setting the trap.
That's why I keep looking past you, he keeps dopping and dunny, the bugger him.
The men have had just 2 days survival training, where they learnt how to set basic traps. But the reality of catching a crocodile that can measure up to 13 feet is a different matter entirely.
This is proper Boy Scout shit, this, isn't it?
He's going to test it.
I'll test it.
Yeah?
Oh, dinner is served. Eh?
That's not bad, is it?
That's all right, that, fellas.
Oh.
That's the one. Let's go.
Let's bust a move.
Back to base, yeah?
Back to base.
Late afternoon. 58-year-old Phil is returning from the water run with the help from Dr. Pierce.
Watch your step.
Yeah.
It's a good thing we didn't carry with a jerry can up and down these rocks.
And home.
While Kyle continues to rest on the beach.
There's a feeling amongst camp that
he's not contributing as much as he should be.
It's just I feel like I've just been trying to deal with the fire and do the water. And Kyle's been kind of doing the feet manicuring bit.
It's a little bit like anything in life, you know, you can have a rest, but do the work first.
It's been almost 2 weeks since Kyle ensured the group's survival by starting a fire with his glasses.
Now, when Kyle first got in here, he
cracked the fire.
It was absolutely brilliant.
Since then,
man's not got a day's graft in him. Not a freaking day's graft in him.
I get the distinct impression, Vic, that you're getting a bit miffed.
I'm just getting me for anybody that springs into my mind that's not sweating as hard as me. Pull your thumb out of your arse, you lazy bastard.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm kind of nearing my physical limit, and I think it's quite a common event. I'll come down and you're doing your feet or you're sitting by the fire. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I feel that perhaps you haven't been pulling your weight in the last week or so.
OK. Today for me has been a bit of a challenging one, actually. Can't lie. I haven't been able to do as much as I thought I would be able to, and, like, when you're in this situation, if you can't contribute, you feel like you're really letting the team down.
Despite the men's best efforts, it's yet another day with empty stomachs.
Bloody hell. Boys, there's no meat on you. You need a bit of cake.
Hey, look, you can see Piers' heart beating through his rib. Look.
Fucking hell.
Being hungry, it really does affect your mental and your physical state. Every step is hard when you're hungry. There would be a stage where soon our bodies give up on us. And we're not far from that.
After over 2 weeks of near starvation, the men's situation is becoming critical.
We're going to Tiger Lily.
Desperate to catch a high-calorie prize, Vic and Dan have set multiple crocodile traps around the island's freshwater lagoon.
Bingo.
But so far, they haven't caught a thing.
By the look of it, it's unsolved all.
Fuck.
Shit.
Nothing, I'm afraid.
On such an extreme, low-calorie diet, you're susceptible to infection and your mental capacity is low. And if nothing changes, really, you're on borrowed time.
Over 2 weeks with barely any food going in, the men's morning routines are anything but regular.
I feel like it's got to that moment where I'm probably going to need to go for a shit soon. When it comes to options, if we've got land or sea, I think I'm going to opt for the sea.
Where are you going to go?
I need to figure out, is it sort of washing that direction or...?
He's going for it.
Carl's taking a dump in the sea.
Good man. Yeah, the most beautiful spot in the world to take a dump in.
Have you joined the poo crew?
So I'm one for, back at home, maybe a 4 to 5 shit a day, man.
A day?
A day?
I'm pretty good. I'm very regular. And I haven't shat until 6:30 this morning, and now I feel enlightened.
God.
I am now part of the poo crew.
But 28-year-old Piers, the group's doctor, isn't having as much success.
How's your,
Oh, the bowels.
Bowels?
Yeah.
Any movement yet?
Being stubborn.
Wow.
No poo for 15 days. It'll come.
Are you ready? Oh, and 1, 2, 3.
With no food to eat, the men still have to expend their energy on vital tasks, like keeping their fire going to boil and purify the water that they collect.
Hello, hello. If you want to get a nice picture of Carl grooming himself, you're quite welcome to do that while we're all getting wood.
Where's that?
Just round the corner doing his toes after he's just had a swim.
Today we were supposed to all contribute getting wood and then do individual tasks, and he has done nothing. I think my tolerance has kind of reached a bit of a limit. You know, if you do let it boil inside you, it does become a bit of a problem when it comes to a head, like it is now.
I can't hold stuff in. I can't.
But listen, when everybody, and in just me, when lots of people bits and chaff and nobody seems to want to confront it, I think, come on, boys, yeah. We're teammates.
Fuck it.
Where is he?
Up there, sat on his arse.
He's taking piss, come on, man, fucking hell. Kyle! Kyle!
I did.
I'm busting my knackers, fella, doing water, and you're doing your feet.
I'm not doing my feet, I've come out of the water.
Whatever.
Yeah.
It's not just me, it just seems that I'm the only one with balls to come up and speak to you.
No, that's fine.
Every fucker's bitching and moaning that you're never doing wood with us. We're all sweating our bollocks off up there, fella, and it looks like...
Yeah, yeah, fair enough.
Looks like you're doing fuck all when it comes to wood.
Admittedly, I'm not getting wood now, because I just come out of water because I went for a shit.
We're fucking pulling tree upon tree upon tree, and it does look like you're always doing your feet. I won't lie to you, it does.
It was almost like a bit of a cheap shot from Vic.
He's clearly got stuff which has been bubbling under the surface.
I felt like I haven't fitted in with the group, and, you know, I've done stuff to try and change that. But sometimes it's just the group dynamics aren't for everyone.
People are starting to fray around the edges. Some of them are fraying, some of them are coming away at the seams. We seriously, seriously need to find a sustainable source of food.
As the men continue to physically decline, the group is becoming fractured. And if members of the group are perceived not to be pulling their weight, they can easily become alienated. And then if those rifts aren't healed, it becomes a downward spiral of conflict that ultimately could destroy the men's community.
Oh, hello. There's a net here.
A net?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Mate, this could be big.
This could make a big difference to us.
Game changer.
Could be. Fellas! Look what I found! We've got ourselves a gill net!
Woo! Fucking brilliant.
It's pretty fucking big!
Yeah. Nice work, get Thomas. In there, baby!
What a whale!
Nice stick of the dog!
Yes! Rah, rah.
Brilliant.
Let's get ourselves some tea!
If we get this net in the water, then we have our best hope yet of catching fish.
For thousands of years, fishermen have been perfecting the art of setting their fishing nets. If you get it right, you unlock the ocean's larder. If you get it wrong, and all they'll be doing is wasting their precious time and precious energy, two resources that they can't afford to waste.
Net's out. Exciting times.
Things are looking up.
Yeah.
Feel quite positive.
I think it will catch fish. I think it might even catch fish for us tonight.
Exhausted after a morning's hard work, the men allow themselves some downtime.
So, boys, here's one. You can request Bear to bring you one item for the journey back.
Thermos full of English breakfast tea.
I am going to get a bottle of Octomore whiskey.
A whole bottle of whiskey?
A whole bottle of Octomore whiskey for my journey back.
Bam.
If I could, chicken pie my wife makes. And she always puts your name in it as well.
Nice.
Oh, the big love heart and all
pop
that sort of thing.
Literally.
Yeah, she's dead right.
He's going to see. You see if it didn't work out with you and your missus. Can you give her a number?
I honestly think there's something wrong with her upstairs, because she really is a nice woman.
How did you find such a nice woman?
I have no idea.
What have you done? You must have a size
not
of a dick
clue.
Of a donkey.
Not a clue, but God bless her.
How did you meet your wife, don't mind me asking?
I went around and knocked on the door.
Did you?
I fucking did, yeah, dead right, I did, yeah.
What did you say?
Hello, I saw you at work today, you turned up to meet your mate. Yeah, I did, yeah, I wonder if I could take you out. Let me think about it. I thought, oh, damn it, she went. Yeah, OK, then.
That's so right. Imagine that you live on the set of Billy Elliot meets Postman Pat.
Absolutely brilliant it was. Aww. So, yeah, well done, me.
Well done, you, mate. Man.
Spotted Piers. Trotting along the beach, looking
vaguely happy with himself. So I think Piers might be off to try and have poo number one. How many days has he been without a poo?
Be 17.
Dr. Piers is now the only member of the group who has not yet joined the poo crew.
Any luck, mate?
No luck today, mate. Here we come.
Here he comes.
Don't do it.
Dr. Piers?
Have we succeeded? Is
no.
it? Is it?
No.
Oh.
Oh, no.
No!
Mission failure. Oh, no. NASA, we have a problem.
Close?
Be patient, lads. Be patient.
Go in your medical kit, get a rubber glove, because I'm going in.
Have fun, boys.
We'll do our best.
Mid-afternoon. After a couple of hours' rest, the men get back to work.
Come on, my son, bite.
2 weeks ago, they were dropped on the island with 8 fishing hooks. But now they're down to just 2.
Shit. Could you unsnag my line? I've caught it on the rock. Oh, shit. Now we've lost another rod there, guys.
Shit, we've lost a hook.
Further down the beach, oil engineer Dan and Dr. Piers swim out to check the net.
What do we think, William? Do you think there's going to be anything on there?
Not saying it. There's lots of rocks. Anything, Barney?
No, sadly not.
We're hoping for the net.
So I've got to see this moment.
Doesn't look like a trawl.
No, I'd go as far as to say it looks like the square root of F4.
What's wrong?
It looks like we'll be going hungry for dinner.
The nets are empty, is that right?
Shit.
What's happening, fella?
This is what we've caught. Caught a load of coral.
Fuck.
The razor-sharp coral has destroyed the men's net.
No fish at all.
Oh.
Shit.
We really are up shit's creek, aren't we?
With no nets.
One fishing hook. The situation just went from bad to much, much worse.
What do you think, Phil? That's disastrous. That's no food for anyone. And no means to get food.
Shit, we've got one hook left. We're fucked.
So we've got one hook to fish for a month.
It's pretty depressing, yeah.
More than one.
No joy with nets. Fuck, are we going to be depleted or what?
Disaster. We're down to our last fishing hook. So the onset of starvation looks upon us.
With morale at rock bottom, Barney, Phil and Sam Farmer head out to the lagoon for the daily check of Vic's crocodile traps.
Chances of catching a caiman, 4%.
The caiman's definitely been here.
How do you know that?
Because the trap is destroyed.
Gosh, look at that.
It's almost certainly been triggered by a caiman. The bait's gone, the trigger's occurred, and it looks like there's been a bit of a struggle, and the rope is firmly in the water.
Well, that is incredibly encouraging in one sense.
Very.
Is there any chance that the caiman could still be on the end?
There is a chance.
Okay.
Fuck, he is.
Is he?
Shit. I think he's under here, isn't he? Is that his back?
No way.
Is this his back here? Come here.
We need to be a bit careful about this. I can see scales on the back of that rope. I can see there are crocodile or caiman-like scales just underneath the water. I'm convinced. Go and have a look. I'm convinced he's there. Just be careful. Be very careful.
There's no doubt about it, the caiman's there.
Yeah.
There is a caiman in the water right next to us now.
We need to be careful, because as soon as we drag him out there, he's going to be angry.
I cannot quite believe it.
No, I can't either. I cannot believe it.
My heart.
Mine too.
Is your heart beating?
Mine too, because he's obviously alive, right?
So the crocodile is the largest, it's the meatiest animal they're going to find on the island. But when they're cornered or they're scared, that's when they're most likely to attack. And if you're in the wrong place at the wrong time, you're in trouble.
The minute we disturb this, all hell will break loose.
The three of us could take him on. I think it's sensible to go and get many more hands. Why don't you two stay here? I'll run back to camp.
Yeah.
Deliver the news.
Yeah.
And we're going to pull him out of that trap.
Yeah. He's going to fight like buggery. Yeah,
absolutely.
Go on, Barney.
Excellent, yes.
Crocodiles can remain submerged for hours before surfacing. And as the lagoon is their ideal habitat, it's certain to be populated by more than just one.
There's definitely an alligator moving this way. It's a little bit weird looking at one that could get you right here. And another one that's heading towards you. It's almost like we're the bait.
Barney's looking excited.
What's up, Barney?
OK, come in, gather in. OK, so we're...
He's running.
I'd say we're 95% sure we've got a caiman in our second trap.
Fuck off.
Let's rock and roll, boys! Let's rock and roll!
I think we nail it. Woo! Let's go!
Let's go!
Oh, this is exciting.
Bingo, big fella!
It's either that or a scaly log.
A scaly log we will eat.
Despite being too exhausted to help with the group's daily tasks, the prospect of a crocodile feast has inspired Kyle to join the hunting pack.
Let's do it, lads.
I feel like Gandalf with my giant shaft.
How are you feeling, Barney?
It's very difficult because I'm so excited and this is all what we want, but when it comes to actually pulling the animal out and having to kill it, I don't know how I feel at all. But at the moment, absolutely buzzing.
Yeah, definitely feel like a tribe on a hunt.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Everyone's come out prepared.
Oh, this is the most excitement I've felt since I've bloody been here.
How are you feeling, Vic?
I'm feeling excited, but we've got a job to do and we dispatch it in a humane manner as we can. But woo! That's how I'm feeling.
When you're hunting crocs, you've got to make sure that you don't become the prey, because these prehistoric beasts are fast. Once they get hold of you, grab you, drag you into the water, and then they strike, bam, lightning speed and incredible power.
What's weird is I can see it and it's got his eye open.
Looking at you.
This thing is going to go absolutely mental. Berserk, yeah. Absolutely mental when it comes out.
Such a blessing. It's a dangerous animal, but we need the food. We need the food.
This way, guys. Barney?
I've got the cavalry.
Bring on the cavalry. Where is it?
It literally is just where you can see that blue rope by the log. The blue rope is wrapped around the caiman.
Oh!
He's big, boys. He's big. OK, he's moving. We need to get a loop over that mouth. I think one of these branches has him pinned. He's making bubbles. I think he's going to do something. Here we go, there we go.
Look at that beauty. He needs to breathe, doesn't he?
He's hissing at us. OK, he's trying to go back.
Here we go, boys. Right, where's that rope with the hook?
Here. Look. OK, boys, we need two people on that rope. We need to pull him ashore.
Is his mouth open?
His mouth is slightly open. OK, Vic.
Nice and calmly, boys.
Come on, Vic.
Whoa, come on, baby.
Come on, Vic.
Right, nobody move because his mouth's open.
Yeah, you get him. You fucking get him.
Let him slide around his neck.
That's it, we got him.
Come on, big boy.
Come on, boys, come on.
Right, I'll distract him. Hey, Mr. Croc. Hey, look at me. Ooh.
Okay, okay, Vic, I go now, go now.
It's probably gonna roll soon.
Over the teeth, over the teeth. Oh, the branch, one more, mate, you've almost got it.
Watch him, go now, go now.
You're in.
Here we go, puppy dog. Go.
Yes.
Watch him.
Right, Sam, I'm very conscious of you stood in the water, mate. Yeah. There is another one in
get
that
out,
lane.
Yeah, get out of there.
Yeah, get on the bank, Sam.
Sam.
Sam, watch his tail.
Sam, get out of the water, mate.
Mate, I think we're good.
There is another one in this lake. If he came along and nipped your heels.
Let's just fucking get this guy. Have we got enough people tugging on that rope?
Yeah, Charles has got it.
There we go.
Right, we now have two.
That's it.
He can still snap, can't he?
Watch his tail on your leg, Sam.
Yeah. I'm on it, don't worry.
I'm staying with you.
Look what it's snapped on now.
This one.
Take your time, fellas.
Right. Don't cut the rope.
Oh, shit. He's growling.
This fucker is fucking powerful.
Give him a minute.
I think he speaks English.
Where's the knife?
I've got a knife with me.
Get the knife out ready.
And then, Carl, what are you doing? You're going to drive the knife.
Take him out.
Right, where are you going to put it?
Just behind his eyes. Right. His skull.
Heads on, guys. Heads on. We go on go. One, two, three. We all go on go.
One. Two, three, go!
Go on, lads, push it in! Push it, lads, that's the one, boys!
Yes, mate, yes!
That's it.
Gentlemen, we have handbags.
Come on!
Last teamwork, fellas.
Take them down, boys! Come on!
Boys!
Back in
there! Damn this game! Oh, he's twitching, he's moving!
Kyle, fucking killer blow, mate. That was awesome.
Get in there, boys! Woo!
Actually wrapping up a dinosaur.
We just caught a prehistoric animal. Damn it!
Amazing. Feels so caveman.
It
feels so caveman.
Yes.
If Pierce doesn't shit after eating a load of this, he's got a serious problem.
And it just...
How many people in the world can say, wrestled a crocodile and killed him?
Yeah.
We are in an elite group of blokes.
After 17 days without anything substantial to eat, the men have finally hit the jackpot and dispatched one of nature's most fearsome predators.
Seeing this, it does make you have respect for crocodiles. This is a big one, really big one, so I just wanted to get it done in a clean way without making a mess of it. To pull it off and grab a croc like this is amazing.
Should we rock and roll then, boys?
Yeah.
One, two,
Kyle.
Yeah.
What would you be doing in your normal life right now?
Back home, it'd be a bit more mundane than this. I definitely wouldn't have a croc on my shoulders.
Seriously, look how much meat there is on that bad boy. Fucking awesome. Yeah.
Not only have the men proved that they're top of the island's food chain, but after surviving on roughly 400 or 500 calories a day, suddenly they've landed themselves a feast of just epic proportions.
Just think of that fucking delicious dinner we're gonna have later, boys.
News of the big catch soon spreads around the island.
Come on, fellas! Oh my god! Holy shit! Oh my god!
No fucking way.
You are absolutely shitting me. That is absolutely enormous.
That's amazing, isn't it?
That is amazing.
Woo!
Yes. Well done, lads.
Fucking hell.
And roll.
Roll.
Get in there, boys.
A croc of this size could provide the men with tens of thousands of calories.
What do you think of that, big boy?
That's beautiful. With some respect to him. Yeah. Out of the water, trap, dispatch, we in 15, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
That's brilliant. I'm pleased about that. We were very respectful of her.
Oh my God, I think I can see a plate of meat coming along.
Oh, hello.
Look at this, boys, as if you didn't need any more motivation.
Today, I managed to catch a bloody crocodile. And my God, was it something. I'm normally at a desk or on a phone talking to clients. I don't kill crocodiles.
God, look at that!
Mate,
get in!
Unbelievable! Wow, look at that! Let the feast begin, boys!
Yes!
Boys get stuck in, it's like chicken.
That is wonderful.
Just had my first taste of crocodile. To me, it just tasted absolutely divine.
It's nice to have a mouth full of meat, isn't it? Not just a nibble. We all get more than we can possibly eat. Here's the heart.
This is Kyle's, the killer.
Kyle, salute you, sir.
Based on the fact that I killed the croc, I was given the privilege of eating its heart. It felt like a good feeling, almost like the prize for doing a good job.
Go on, Kyle.
Feel like you're inheriting its strength.
Like
a boss.
Oh, fuck, that was nice. God, that was nice. Oh, that second piece I took was beautiful. Oh, God, I feel like I have to Sunday dinner at home. Absolutely lovely. What a lovely, lovely feeling that is.
I feel sorry for Piers, because he needs to open his bowels, otherwise it's going to be painful.
Oh, he's going to open them after this.
So I was absolutely dead on my feet earlier. Completely and utterly gone. And suddenly the morale boost the team needed that so badly to kick the spirits up.
I think this counts as, just for today, if nothing else, more than surviving.
...6 a.m. Dr. Piers is feeling the benefit of last night's feast.
Here you've got some big news for me.
Yeah, I am the last member of the Poo Club.
Last man
squad. Well done, Piers. Everyone give Piers a round of applause?
Yes!
Yes, Piers.
Brilliant.
Yes, Piers. How did it feel?
It felt great, actually. Really good. I thought it was going to be really hard. I thought it was going to be like rabbit droppings stuck together.
Oh, what was it like?
Like a wet sausage.
A wet sausage?
Yeah. Dreamy. Absolutely dream. Yeah. So that croc pushed it all down.
Lads, croc's ready.
With plenty of crocodile meat still left over, cameraman Ross serves up breakfast.
Char grilled to smoky perfection.
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
I think it's better.
I think it's better than the S02.
With their bellies full, the men set about their daily chores.
Look at that. We have done wood in the same time it took Kyle to get dressed. Tell me that ain't the greatest thing.
Right.
Team effort, boys.
I feel like I can just lie on this beach right now and think about nothing and do nothing and not feel guilty for the first time pretty much since we got here.
Is this for your personal collection?
This is only for me.
I thought that camera was a bit slower.
That's it. That's it.
Oh, what?
Lovely. Enjoy the idyllic tropical sunshine. I think life isn't too bad after all.
For the second night in a row, the men anticipate a hearty feast of crocodile meat.
Does everyone fancy the last of the croc?
I would love a bit. Yeah.
As well as giving the group vital calories, the sudden intake of rich food appears to have solved another of the men's problems.
Dan, how are your ablutions this afternoon?
Oh, Danny had a trump and a follow-through, didn't he?
He shit himself this afternoon while he was making his bed.
Dribbling down my leg.
Just a little bit. A little bit of boo came out.
I just squeezed my socks out. Who's that bad?
Oh, God.
Well, you fucking asked, didn't you?
Crocodile broth this evening. It's going to be superb.
Come on, boys, dig in, please.
Pass it around.
How is it, Vic?
Oh, it's strong. I think strong is a good word.
There is some distinct smell of poo about this.
It smells a bit like dog shit, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does smell a bit suspicious, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Shit. Oh, crikey.
Phil, what's the verdict?
I've had two mouthfuls, and that's two mouthfuls too many.
I can feel the squirts coming on.
The 30-degree tropical heat has spoiled the remains of the crocodile, leaving the men, once again, with nothing to eat.
The final meal from our croc, it was basically rotten meat. It was pretty... I don't want to think about it too much. It was pretty much the worst thing I've ever had in my life.
Oh, dear.
When your shoulder pays.
Yeah?
Well, tonight marked the end of our crocodile feast. From now on, we've got no more meat to eat. Now that crocodile has dried up, we need another source of food now.
Oh, my God! What's that? Is that Andrew? Oh, my God!
Tomorrow night on the Women's Island...
Oh, my God!
Thoughts turn to food.
I think a bogey just came out of my nose.
Eat it!
Waste nothing!
Oh, my God, there's two piglets!
The first thing I thought of was crackling.
So we'll see how the women are getting on tomorrow night at 9 on their island. Straight after at 10, the brand new series of The Last Leg is back, and it kickstarts with guest Piers Morgan, which I'm pretty sure is okay to most people. Next tonight, the programme that reassures you're definitely not the only one that's awkward on a first date. Maybe the oysters will help.